I'm Lasse-Dissing Olesen. I'm a postdoc fellow at the Boston Children's Hospital in the lab of Dr. Beth Stevens. I have since my undergrad worked on microglia cells, which are the resident immune cells in the brain. And I'm a passionate scientist in diving into understanding what the role of these microglia cells in the brain. We now know they play a crucial role for brain development, for how the brain is wired. And I find it fascinating to dive into understanding what the role is for these cells. So doing my PhD work, I worked on a very interesting receptor on the microglia cells called P2Y12. It's a purinergic receptor, meaning it's sensing ATP and ADP, which is crucial for microglia to sense the environment. And it's crucial for microglia, like for the process motility of the microglia. So I fell in love with that protein. But when I started my postdoc, there's no good antibodies available to actually, you know, assess this protein in our common assays, like immunohistochemistry as well as flow cytometry. So we partnered up with BioLegend in terms of, can we generate an antibody that is selective to target P2Y12? And we have succeeded in doing that, and it's a powerful tool to identify microglia cells that express the P2Y12 protein. It's expressed on the surface of the cells, so it's ideal for flow cytometry, because you can identify live cells by using this antibody that targets P2Y12 on the surface to identify these microglia cells, which distinguish them for other tissue-resident macrophages as well as monocytes in the blood. So for neuroscience in particular, maybe, the tools are sometimes what drives it. And so sometimes a new tool opens new avenues. And you know, if you're on the forefront and you're working on a new tool, or you're partnering up with people that can provide a new tool, well, it opens up new avenues of research for us as scientists. And that's exciting, because sometimes these tools just, you know, get you into territories you didn't think about before. And there's a lot of examples, but so one of the strong tools that have been, you know, valid for across fields of research is antibodies, in terms of both for immunohistochemistry, for flow cytometry, for Western blots, for ELISA, and that won't change. I mean, we get more powerful ways of assessing the genome and looking at proteins in proteomics levels, but in the end of the day, a lot of times we want that validation with specific antibodies, and biology has just given us a beautiful repertoire of selectivity if we get the antibodies right. My vision with this partnership with BioLegend is that we continue what we've done so well with the P2Y12 antibody. I think that's a proof of concept, that the constellation of going back and forth in validation, having constant communication, how does it work? I mean, how do we test it the best way? How do we set this rigorous standard? So I think that gives us an edge, and it gives the scientific community hopefully tools down the road that they can do. So I'm happy to be engaged in this, and I think it's something to move forward with.